That was rough.
Thank you.
This looks important. That looks important. This looks important.
Paxulpec, it is here. Friend Paxulpec, it returns. But of course it has. Long ago the Paxulpec and I spoke of songs and... Ah, of course. It is not the same Paxulpec. Forgive me. The horns. It does not have them. A new friend, then. Hmm? So what brings it to beleaguered Yesha? Truly? Then it treads the very path it seeks. The ancient temple was built to imprison such a beast. It now serves as its lair. Alas, the great water heart which tales tell once opened the temple has been shattered for an age and an age. There is no hope without its song. Yet beware, friend Paxultec, for the Ravager has been killed before. There is none more powerful than that which shakes off death like fallen leaves. I will do my best to answer. Quite so. Paxultec have graced this world for generations. The Elder, the one it calls Ford. The Destroyer, to whom many faces fell. The Wanderer, who faced the Ravager and lived. Alas, songs are not song of Paxultec, but I am blessed to have met many. If I seek hope, friend Paxultec, Yaisha is broken. Corruption waxes while the tree wanes. The balance groans in pains of birth. Yet through it all, the song of Aphir has hung in the air. One could always hear it in the wind and water, sand and star. I came to the temple hoping to hear its melodies once more, not on the wind, but in plain truth as it was meant to be. Alas, I fear the song is lost forever, destined to live in memory alone. There is much to tell, though, alas, I am no scholar. Suffice to say, the Ravager and Doe are the heart of this world, the very essence of the balance. The Doe is life, the Ravager, death, each necessary in equal measure, if the Lamir are to be believed. Yet now, the Ravager serves the rot, the corruption that ingests Yesha piece by piece with each passing day. I do not know what will become of our mother, but I trust the songs. So long as we have music, we have hope. Ah, a tragic tale woven into many ballads. The story of the Water Harp is the story of Yesha and the Balance. It is the story of the Pan. The great wolf, the Ravager, decimated our people. It was said that it could not be killed, for to do so would upset the balance and bring upon us even worse calamities. So the harp was fashioned to soothe the beast with music. And soothe it did, but only for a time. The beast escaped, silencing the harp in the process, ending its song for long and long. The beast is chaos, and the balance ineluctable. The balance does not concern itself merely with life and death, love and hate, freedom, suppression. The balance governs all. May it return again.
Here they come. come.
Glad that's over. This isn't looking good.
Thank you.
That's over.
Thank you. Is it over?
Okay, this is...
Welcome back, Sunshine.
It's strange how quiet it is here some days. Like, nothing's going on.
Let me know if you see something you need.
Kind of boring, if you ask me. I'd like a little more adventure in my life sometimes.
Oh, yeah? Well, we can sneak off.
Need anything? I'm here.
Bag's full.
Summons me from my ethereal wanderings.
Nuzar! What kind of beast is this? Paxeltek. I can share my wanderings with you. But first, I seek the knowing, the truth of nature held within your ark. You want to answer? So I will ask. Answer these questions true. Sweet beast, so that your ark may be known and your eye may open. And do choose wisely. Answer from your heart. It is wartime, and you and your two children, ages 8 and 5, live in a territory that has been captured by the enemy. Among the enemy is a Lamir who performs painful experiments that inevitably lead to death. He demands one of your children, the weaker one, giving you 24 hours to bring them to his laboratory. If you refuse, enemy soldiers will come for all of you. Do you give up one of your children, or face the threat of enemy soldiers? Oh, what fun this is! A handsome and powerful god visits Yasha with the promise to eradicate conflict, disease, and all suffering. In return, he demands a sacrifice, the life of a single young Pan. Do you give him what he asks? Now let me think. Oh, yes! He that slew your sibling and escaped justice is incapacitated before you. You could slay him then and there in cold blood. Do you take your vengeance? Or turn the scum over to the authorities from whom he already escaped? I see. A runaway cart races down the track toward 5 miners. You and a stranger are on a footbridge above, witnessing this. The stranger, who happens to be very large, leans over the rail to get a better look. You could save the lives of the 5 miners by shoving him onto the track below, stopping the cart with his bulk. Do you push the stranger, or risk the death of the 5 miners? Fascinating!
An elder leads a group to a cave on the sea coast. The poor fellow falls, trapped beyond reach and unconscious. In a short time, high tide will be upon him, and he will likely drown. A spell worker among the troop possesses a charged crystal of explosive power.
It could be used to collapse the cave and halt the tide. But it is very dangerous. Do you leave the Elder to his fate? Or do you attempt to halt the tide at the risk of his life? I see. You have chosen your path, sweet beast. Your heart is true. May the power of the Doe's Eye free you from your incarnate shackles. In the arc of every being, there are two eyes. We may see out of either, but most favor one over the other. The Ravager's Eye is dynamic, driven, and endlessly hungry. Yet for all its power, its vision is clouded. The Eye of the Ravager rarely sees beyond its own satiation. Like an animal chasing its tail, it knows no rest. The Doe's Eye sees only what is before it. The gift of the Doe is subtle, easily missed. It is a most mysterious presence inside oneself, conferring power without force. Just as the Doe itself cannot be sought, nor tracked, nor hunted. By answering true, sweet beast, you give me a wink, and now the gifts of your dominant eye will be open to you. Would you care to hear a tale? It is about those who see as you do. I will tell you of Ramaril, the servant child of the Vaunt. I found Ramaril as a babe, large and angry as only a hungry babe can be. Nothing became of him as it happened. He grew from a great crying babe to a great quiet Pan. He served without word or complaint. None knew his name, for though one might thank the creator of a meal or a washroom, who even considers the child who merely cleans up after? When the Krell came, they laid siege to the temple. None could escape nor call for help. All were doomed. The Doe's Eye opened in Ramaril that day. He was no fighter and had no training of any kind. But he lifted the largest shield he could find and told the others to run once he'd made away. He drove dozens of Krell over a cliff, and himself with them. Later, his masters came to me seeking to know more of this boy who had saved them, whom I had laid at their doorstep. I told them many stories. One might even consider them true. Is there anything else? Knowledge of me? Of our wonderful world? You stand before Myrdra, spirit of the natural world, daughter of stem and stream. My sisters and I are the glorious weavers of all wild beauty. When mountain, spring, and sturdy tree trunk take your breath, sweet beast, that is us. That is our blessing. An immeasurable number. Mother Stem and Mother Stream rely on us to sprawl and grow. Though we don't often commune with beasties such as you. Not in this age. Especially not since what happened to Kaola. A tragedy, beast. Tragedy most cruel. Kaola was fascinated by mortals, by your lives and stories. Unlike most of us, she made herself no secret. And you worshipped her with your short lives, even built her a house. A temple, you called it. The root found her there. We godlings are not easily unwoven, however. And it slew her not. But perhaps it would be better if it had. For what remains is no longer the sister I knew. But we hold happy thoughts. Regret only wastes one life with another. Is there something else we can talk about? By day, a dappled glade of emerald branch and golden leaf, carpeted by downy moss. By night, sweet beast, the trees bewitch the lost and inebriated. Or so it was before this age of extermination. How I long to return to play. This age, for me, holds only decay. This has been just a lovely distraction.
ask, Paxultek, and I will listen. Yes, ask its question. The blessing of Geisha go with it. This looks important.
traveled.